Well, another January 2023 release. I really thought this film playing was going to be trash, but it turned into another decent surprise. Certainly not a great film, but it's also not one of the worst films either. So the saying of January Dump Month is a thing of the past. Now the story of this one is that a commercial pilot must do an emergency landing in one of the islands in the Philippines. And when a bunch of passengers get kidnapped by an anti-government militia group, then this pilot must team up with a prisoner in order to save them. Now I admit, when I had first heard about this film a couple of weeks ago, I thought it was going to be awful. But with this film being entertaining with its story, especially the two main characters, this is a film that's a throwback to the 90s action films. Sure, there's not like a whole bunch of macho cheese, and there's not even like the typical one-liners you'll find in those movies. But for the most part, the characters feel human, and not just that, but there also were some good moments in this film. And I must say, for a B-action movie that felt like should have came out more than two decades ago, this does a good job at telling a well-thought-out story. At the end of the day, though, if you haven't seen this film, I say check it out. It's not better than other airplane movies out there, but it's still an enjoyable ride. Now, the acting, it actually was done really well. Gerard Butler, who plays Broly Torrance, he's not your everyday action hero. He makes mistakes, and his goal is to make sure his passengers are safe. In fact, the action in this film is not over the top. This guy, he's not going around mowing down the bad guys. He's just being real smart about it. I also like the actor from Mike Coulter playing Louis Gaspar, the prisoner. And so when both of them team up, they obviously have to save the passengers. And a lot of the times I was thinking, you know, if this film would have came out in the 90s, it would have been a summer release. The lead actors probably would have been either Arnold Schwarzenegger or Sylvester Stallone. You know, some of the biggest action heroes during the time. But, you know, for a January release, the story in this film, you know, it works. It's a throwback to 90s classics. And while this movie is not Con Air, because there is no memorable villains, literally you won't find a Cypher the Virus or any of those villains in that film, because the villains in this one, they're just generic bad guys. They weren't interesting. They really didn't have any backstory. I was like, okay, whatever. One thing I found that was hilarious in this film, the passengers, there's less than 20 of them. I've been on two plane rides last year, and both of them were full, so I was really thinking, alright, that's really unrealistic. I guess the writers was like, hey, let's put up a little bit of passengers in this film, so there's not a huge list of characters. Nonetheless, though, I think this film is enjoyable for what it is. It's not one of the best movies I've seen, but it's an enjoyable time. And not only that, but if you're a fan of Gerard Butler movies, then definitely give this one a chance. I'm giving this film a 7 out of 10. This is a decent popcorn movie, a film that you can turn your brain off and just have an enjoyable time. Now, there are some scenes in this film that goes by way too fast. I was like, all right, that escalated pretty quickly. And overall, while everybody won't like this film, it does a good enough job telling a convincing enough story where it's believable. And the two main characters are really the standout of this film as well. And speaking of which, Gerard Butler and Mike Coulter really did carry this film. I wanted to know what their characters were about and seeing how it all came together towards the end. And while this film does have its flaws, it's not enough to make this one unwatchable. And that's my review of the film, Plane. Okay, leave your comments down below in the section and let me know what you think about this movie if you have seen it. Alright, this is Slim Guy 172 saying, peace out.